temperatures over here in the western sections of the country, and that could also affect us here in the valley. Temperatures will cool down somewhat tomorrow. The overnight lows will be in the upper 20s in the high hills to the mid-50s in the southwest deserts. The highs tomorrow will range from the mid-50s in the hills to the mid-70s here in the deserts. For the greater Phoenix area, we call for mostly sunny, a little warmer today, high today near 80, increasing high cloudiness tonight. The low tomorrow morning at Sky Harbor will be somewhere in the mid-50s. Considerable sunshine, a slight chance of showers Tuesday, the high in the mid-70s. What are the odds? The probability of measurable rain tomorrow will be about 10%. I still think it's worthy of saying good-looking weather for good-looking people. Let's continue now with Today in Arizona. Here's Diane.
Thank you, Bob. Now, this morning, first on Today in Arizona, especially for you, Leslie Brown and Richard Fine, dancers from the Arizona Ballet Theater's production, Swan Lake.
Thank you.
You just saw the beautiful dancing of Leslie Brown and Richard Fine, and as I said, they will be starring in the production of Swan Lake, put on by the Arizona Ballet Theatre. I'm sure that you would agree with me that it is extremely difficult to get up at this very early hour of the morning and to perform at this very early hour of the morning, and we're very much grateful to them. Why don't you step right over here and we'll chat a little bit if you have any breath left at all. We thank you very much for guesting on Today in Arizona this morning, and I know you're very worn out. Is this, Leslie, the first time that you have done Swan Lake, or have you performed it before?
No, it's the first.
Now, you both are from Phoenix, as I understand it. Natives of Phoenix, are you not?
I am. No, I'm from New York, originally.
I see.
And our parents moved out to Phoenix about 8 years ago.
And I've never lived in Phoenix.
How about that? I was mistaken. Okay, we get me corrected there in a hurry. Richard, I was reading a little bit about your background. Surely not enough, because I would have known that way that you did not live in Phoenix. But I read that you recently toured with Rudolf Nureyev. Did
yes.
you not?
Yes. Last season I was with the National Ballet of Canada on the United States tour, and Rudy was with them. It was quite an experience.
I bet it was. What is it like to work with a man like Nureyev?
That really can't be summed up in the amount of time that we have. It's a tremendous experience. It's a total learning experience. There's nothing that he does that you can't learn from.
That's tremendous. I'm sure you admire him a great deal. As you were growing up, Leslie, and studying ballet and practicing very hard, did you have an idol, somebody that you were trying to imitate, let's say?
Yeah, I really like Margot Fonteyn, and I've always loved her.
Now, your family danced, did they not?
Mm-hmm.
Your mother and father? So this is not an unusual situation in
no,
your household.
No, it's like part of my life all the time.
How about your family, Richard? Are you the first one to go into dancing?
Yes, the first one to go into any art. And, my family's all very proud, and I'm...
At what age did you make this decision?
About 16, I started dancing.
I'm sure it must take a great deal of self-discipline, a great deal of regular practice to stay up with it all, doesn't it?
Constantly.
I also read that both of you, and I hope I'm right on this, are students studying under a Ford grant, have scholarships under Ford grants.
Mm-hmm.
How do you get such a scholarship? Leslie, maybe you could tell us, do you apply for it, or was it just given to you?
Well, it was just given to us because... Jelana, who is a principal with the New York City Ballet, came and taught a master class, and she just offered me a scholarship. I took the class, and it was lucky.
That's great. And how about you? How did you come by this?
I was in New York, and I auditioned for it at the school, and was given it to me.
Are there, and I myself am not too familiar with other metropolitan areas, of course, as much as I am about Phoenix, but are there quite a few local ballet companies around the country, such as the Arizona Ballet Theatre?
All over. There are regional ballets in every part of the country now, and it's growing very rapidly. The last 10 years has been the renaissance for ballet in the United States, really.
It has then become more popular, let's say, recently.
Very much so, very much so. People, I think, feel that it really is something you can do for a career, as opposed to the old image of the theater. You know, people who were in the theater were supposed to be unstable and, you know, not trustworthy and all that, and I think that image has really changed recently, and especially in ballet.
How would you compare the popularity of ballet in the United States with other countries, say European countries, or of course Russia? I guess everybody always thinks of Russia immediately when you think of ballet.
Well, the Americans have their own style, that's certain. I suppose that America has more dancers than any other country in the world. Perhaps that's because they have the greatest population, too. But in Europe, Germany has opera ballet companies all over the country, and Sweden and places like that. It's worldwide.
Some very important information that we have not conveyed to you as yet, and I'll let Leslie do that. Just when is this production? Where is it? And let's get all the information about it.
It's Saturday, March 30th, this Saturday, and it's at the Phoenix Civic Plaza, and there's a matinee at 2 and an evening at 8.
Great. And so I imagine advance ticket sales are available.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, advance tickets are available at the box office
right.
at the Phoenix Civic Plaza. How long have you been practicing for this particular performance?
Since after Christmas. Right after Christmas.
It takes a long time to perfect it. I love the music from Swan Lake, and I have to admit that I have never seen it, and I'm going to try very hard to get there Saturday night because I would like to see it. How many people are in the cast? Is it a large cast?
Yes, for a ballet, there are 16 girls in the corps, and three other hunters, and the villain of the ballet, Von Rothbart, and the two of us.
Magnificent music, Tchaikovsky's music. Mm. I have time to ask you each one more question. What do you ultimately want to attain in your dancing career? You, I'm sure, must have a goal way up there someplace, and I'd like you to share that with us, Richard.
Wow. I just want to have a full dancing career, and that's about as many words as I can put into it, just so that I have the opportunity to dance as much as I can, all the time, if I could.
It's very important to you, I'm sure.
It is. It's the most important.
Leslie? Could you share some thoughts with us on that?
I think I'd like to dance as long as it makes me happy, and that's what I want to do.
Is there a particular role that you haven't had an opportunity to do as yet that you would like to do?
Probably Giselle.
Okay. Well, I wish you both the best, and it will be at Symphony Hall this Saturday, Swan Lake, performed by the cast of the Arizona Ballet Theatre. Leslie Brown and Richard Fine, we thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.
Thank you.
A tour of this sandwich will show you three good reasons to buy Plumrose sliced ham. One, Plumrose is consistently lean ham. There's hardly any fat. Two, Plumrose has a juicy Danish flavor. And three,